G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and in this video I just want to show you the different parts of a truss. So here we have a typical truss, except this one has a cantilever, but the overall shape and everything except for that member there is pretty normal for standard trusses. So the first part of a normal truss is our top chord. So in this case, of course, it's a triangular truss. It has two top chords, one on this side as well. If it was a parallel truss, where the top chord is parallel to the bottom chord, then you would only have one top chord. But top chord, topmost member of the truss. And of course, already mentioned the bottom chord, the lower member of the truss, normally forms your ceiling joist. In between the top and the bottom chord, we have the webs. So these tie together the top and the bottom chord, give the truss its strength, and holding all them together are nail plates or gang nails, which are normally pressed into place with a hydraulic press. We then have longitudinal braces, which run the length of the roof but at 90 degrees to the truss, which tie the bottom cord of all the trusses together and braces things up. And we also have a web tie brace as well, which pretty much does the same thing as a longitudinal brace, helps to stiffen up the roof and tie it all together. We have this member here, which is a cantilevered web, and as I said before, the only reason that's here is because we have a cantilevered section on this truss and we need a point to take the support where that load is going to go onto that wall. So that's a cantilevered web, wouldn't normally be seen in a standard truss. A pitching point, or the part where it sits on the wall, is generally out where the bottom chord meets the top chord, although again, because of the cantilever on this side, it's here, but it would normally be out in this area here. The overall length of the truss, from the outside of the overhang to the outside of the overhang, our overhangs is the distance from the outside of the truss to the wall, okay, to the inside of that pitching point. And then the nominal span is the inside measurement that the truss spans. So inside that wall to inside that wall is your nominal span. And we still have this area left over on this particular truss, and that's our cantilever. So that's our cantilever. So there you go, there's some common members and some common terminology used with trusses.